Oh my god, it's a surprise. Breaking news. Shocking news. Kim Kardashian filed for divorce after 72 days of marriage. It's such a surprise, right? Now, let me say this here very loud and very clear. Me. This is my belief. This is how I feel. This is my input. This is my outlook on the subject. Everybody's entitled to their own opinions. Don't bash me. Go to the source. I'm not the source. This is just how I feel about it. Now, if you don't know who Kim Kardashian is, you've been living under a rock. This girl is known around the world. This girl is a brand. She's the queen of endorsements. She has endorsement deals with Quick Trim. What is that? A diet supplement. She has a collection at BB. She has multiple of her own fragrances. She's part owner of ShoeDazzle.com, which sells shoes or whatever. She has a cupcake named after her called Baba Vanilla at a boutique in California. Motherfucking pastries. This girl is made of money. People love this girl. Now, the internet has been gone by storm. You know, Ryan Seacrest was the first person to confirm that Kim Kardashian filed for her divorce today. Halloween! Kim Kardashian filed for divorce. And Twitter has this boy rampage. She's a trending topic. Like, this just hit things by storm. Now, although Kim Kardashian is known now for something negative and a negative light, she took it and she ran with it. You know, there was the sex tape that leaked back in 2007 with Ray J, and that's how she rose to fame. She had a sex tape with Ray J, which was sold to some company named Vivid. She sued Vivid, and then she dropped the charges and settled for $5 million so that the video would no longer be circulation. So, you know, Kim Kardashian has been linked to lots of famous people, you know, but the big name is, you know, Ray J for the sex tape. Then she was a longtime girlfriend to Reggie Bush, and now Chris Humphrey. I didn't know who Chris Humphrey was until I heard that he was linked to her and I was watching E or whatever. This girl, estimated gross off of her wedding is $17.9 million. She's already made of money. Already made of money. And the girl still making money. What amuses me, she didn't come out of pocket not 1 cent. People sponsored, companies sponsored her wedding. She had 3 wedding dresses by Vera Wang. You don't know who Vera Wang is? You need to go Google her. Not one wedding dress, but 3 dresses by Vera Wang. She had 440 guests. Think about all the people there. Think about all the celebrities. Publicity. I feel like this is a publicity stunt. From the get-go, I never felt that this relationship was mutual. I never felt that it was a true connection. Although she's made the money, she's not going to stop. She's going to continue to do it. And, you know, the publicity for the next couple weeks, they're going to bash her. It's not going to only affect her. It's going to affect her family. It's going to affect how people look at her, how people perceive her. Me as an individual, if I was in a situation like this, that's going to hurt me emotionally. That's going to hurt me more than anything. Her pockets are not going to be suffering at all. Do you know how many people are probably contacting her? You know how many radio stations are probably contacting her? TV hosts, sponsors, endorsement deals, trying to get the first verbal, you know what, conversation of what really happened between their divorce. I feel like she lied to her fans and had a falsified wedding. That's how I feel. You know, she always talked about having the wedding of her dreams. She was in love with Reggie Bush. This girl was in love with this man. On Tyra Banks' show, Tyra asked, if Reggie came to you and asked you to marry you today, what would you say? She said yes. Tyra didn't even finish the question. This girl was in love with Reggie Bush. She dated Chris Humphries for 6 months before he proposed. How do you know in 6 months that you want to be with this man for the rest of your life? Marriage is about unison. It's about two people becoming one that you have that much of a connection with that you don't feel like you can live your life without that person. It's about unison. It's about commitment. Making a vow till death do us part. I feel like society just feels like marriage is not sacred anymore. And this is just my outlook on it. And no matter how much negativity comes your way, she's still making bread. She's still going to be making bread to the day that she dies. And I feel like, what does that say about her integrity? You know, I'm not Kim Kardashian. I didn't marry her. You know, I don't know the truth behind it, but this is my outlook on it. This is how I feel, that it was a business proposition. She went into it thinking like, oh, if we get married, more money. Everybody's going to be asking us questions. She probably had numerous interviews. This girl's making money. Not a surprise. It's just sad. You know, people take marriage and screw it up like it's just an everyday thing. I believe that marriage is sacred. You're supposed to get married one time. That one time. She's been married for 72 days and she filed for divorce. What about counseling? What about working things out? What about talking? Like, if you are so in love and this is your soulmate, oh, I just remember you saying less than a year ago that Reggie Bush was your soulmate. However, where's the work? Why are you not putting forth the effort to try and make it work? It's just really crazy to me, and I feel like it was a publicity stunt. You know, I said that about Mariah Carey and Nick Cannon, too, but they're still together. You know, people said that about Chloe and Lamar. They're still married. So who knows? It just seems a little sketchy. That's my point of view. Like this video if you liked it, and please feel free to leave your comments in the comments box below on how you feel about the Kim and Chris divorce. Talk to y'all soon. Bye.